Hi, this is Brady Volpe. I'm going to give a brief demonstration of the P&M Cloud application by NimbleDisk. You start off by logging in by entering your email address and then your password, and simply click Login. The first screen you come to is the general dashboard, and you have to select the CMTS that you want to look at, and that will present you with various information. We'll see the total of number of cable modems that are in this dashboard or on the particular CMTS, the total number of cable modems that are what we call red severity, meaning ones that are having problems. These are the ones we really want to focus on. And we have also ones that are of medium severity. We have 63 of those, and then we have 180 cable modems that really don't have many problems at all. So we don't care much about these because they're in pretty good shape. The orange, medium severity, so we could take a look at these if we wanted, but the reds are the ones that we're more concerned about. And we can click on each cable modem. This is the cable modem MAC address, so we can cycle through these. We see the equalizer taps for these particular cable modems, and then we see the frequency response. So we can see there's a lot of ripple here in this particular cable modem. It has a peak to valley of about plus 2 to almost minus 2, so 4 dB peak to valley. The DOCSIS standard tells us we need plus or minus 0.5 dB peak to valley. So clearly the upstream for this cable modem is well outside of specifications. We also see we have microwave reflections at minus 30 dBc, a delay of about 2007 nanoseconds, group delay. And then in our TDR field, our time domain reflectometer, we estimate that the distance to whatever impairment, possibly a corroded connector or some other impairment in our return path that's causing these microreflections, is about 2,567 feet away from the cable modem. So this helps us a lot identify where these issues are. Now what I'm interested in is, you know, possibly mapping this and looking at these impaired cable modems on CMTS. So I'm going to go to my map, and then I'm going to select CMTS2. So there's CMTS2 here, and as my map loads up, I see first a lot of green, a lot of yellows. It's kind of difficult to see where the reds are, so I'm going to eliminate my greens and yellows and just focus on the red, and we'll go ahead and hide that. So now we can quickly zoom in on my reds, and we'll zoom in a little bit more on my reds here. And now we can see there's a lot of areas here, and if I want, I can hide my circles and just hover over one of these particular modems. We see our MAC address, we see the address of this particular cable modem, and the distance to the impairment is 2,330 feet. So I turn my circles back on. This does help me sort of localize the impairment. If I look at this particular cable modem and its MAC address, and I see its circle, we see there's a common area right in the center here where all of our impairments are overlapping. So we should have a pretty good idea that there's probably an active device or something along the mainline cable that is equally impacting all of the cable modems. And if we look at the loop of this, we're probably thinking it's right in about this area. So this gives a very good sense of exactly where we should send our technician. Now, if we had a GIS mapping system where we could overlay all of our trunk lines, our feeder lines, our bridger amplifiers and nodes, we'd be able to see exactly where the common point is on that. So we can integrate the system with GIS systems and these geolocation coordinates with that to go ahead and see this. Now, how do we get this data in to the P&M system? We have a setup system where we go ahead and we put in the CMTS name, its IP address, its public community stream. We can enable background polling, and we can set up, what hours we would like the background polling to occur. What interval do we want it to occur? Once every 12 hours, or once every 3 hours, maybe once every 24 hours, and we would save those settings. We could also manage the CMTSs, so we can see the CMTSs that are online, their polling intervals, how frequently they poll, and that gets us our data. We can do bulk uploads, so if we just want to import the data, if we don't want to use SNMP, we can use a flat file and update it, and then we go back into our summary and select a CMTS and look at that files and process it. So we can look at the clean modems, look at ones that aren't bad, but typically we're going to be looking at the red ones. So overall, that's a summary of what is available here. There is an API that enables all of this data to be pushed and pulled directly into the back-end system so that operators who do already have analysis systems and dashboards in place can use the processing power, the complex algorithms that are going on in order to analyze the cable modem coefficients, to create the frequency response, look at all these different values, and create the time domain reflectometer, look at the micro reflections. All this complex math can be done within this system and then pulled back into the cable operator's back office system. So that's one of the features of the API that's included here. So that's a very high-level summary, very quick summary of what this system is capable of. It's very powerful. It offers tremendous capabilities for analyzing cable networks, DOCSIS cable networks, much more than what we've ever had in the past. So, hope you've enjoyed this overview and take advantage of the power of this system. Thank you.